صاحب الصلاة أشرف المؤمنين القرآن الأصحاب الكرام تقبل تقبل رحمة الله سبحانه إن شاء الله بلا ملك mengikut jadual yang telah ditambah salah kita akan mengikut program yang dipimpin oleh Syekh Sayyid Hafifuddin. Salah saya akan membaca sedikit by Dr. Sayyid Hafifuddin dalam salah safah hebat. InsyaAllah Syekh Hafifuddin ini tuan-tuan di antara generasi yang ke-18 daripada Sultan Al-Mulia Ibn Hussein Kutub Al-Qutab Al-Baqul Al-Qutab Al-A'adham Asyik Sayyid Mahdi Ibn Qadir Al-Jailani Al-Hasani Wal-Husi Pada Allah Sahabat Al-Qutab. Maksudnya Syekh kita ini adalah keturunan yang ke-18 daripada Syekh Fadil Al-Jailani. Tentu pada Al-Jailani, Syekh Fadil Al-Jailani telah lahir pada tahun 470 Hijrah dan wafat pada tahun 561 Hijrah. Hidup selama 1 tahun. Syekh Fadil Al-Jailani adalah seorang Sultan Al-Awliya, wali segala wali, wali Allah, ya. Jadi kita harus berdoa, kita berada dapat terbang dengan yang punya keturunan dari Syekh Fadil Al-Jailani yang ke-18. Syekh Hafifuddin ini juga adalah di antara tiga keturunan yang ke-33 daripada Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Beliau merupakan salah seorang daripada pemimpin tarekat Qadariyah dan mempunyai kepakihan bidang fikih dan undang-undang syariah dan juga tasawuf. Salah seorang daripada yang mengapa kata mufti daripada kerajaan Arab yaitu Maulana Syekh Abdul Karim Al-Madaris. Syekh Hafifuddin Al-Jailani telah dianugerahkan satu anugerah yang tinggi oleh Syekh Abdul Karim Al-Mudabbis, yaitu satu pujian Al-Hijada Al-Amiyah yang merupakan satu penghormatan yang tertinggi yang begitu penting untuk menjadi seorang pendakwah dan juga guru. Syekh Hafifuddin juga telah mempelajari daripada ulama-ulama Islam segala yang lain. Tuan-tuan dan puan-puan, ingat sekarang ini saja yang saya telah bacakan mengenai berita dari Syekh Sayyid Hafifuddin Al-Jailani. Falyatafaddal ya Rasulullah.
Terima kasih. بشرح صدري ويستمر بعد بعضة من رسالة أكثر القرن. الحمد لله الله تبارك سبحانه وتعالى ويميتنا تنايت اسم ليس Gandhi. He said in his book, One day he was attending a meeting or conference. He saw a group of Muslims. They came to have the conference call. He saw them, you know, the one who's on the right, the one on the left, allow the one who's right to enter first. Although maybe he's the leader of the delegation, but he allowed the one who's right to enter first. So they entered in front of him, like one way, in a very difficult way. Who are these people? They said they are the Muslims. And he said, why they are entering the conference hall this way? They said, because they call that this is the Prophet's sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullah, he is the one who ordered them to do that. He said, how great man is he to make the people evil? He told them that to house or how to return to conference. I have more about him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, here. But from those who they said about, but one of them, from Julius Masselman of USA, he was one of the famous professors. He said, perhaps the greatest leader of all times was Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For him, after telling him, alayhi wa sallam. I'll give you one of my own experiences. 2005, I was in Sony USA, also Dawah from Basmati. I met somebody, an American professor. He's a lecturer in the university, San Francisco, I met him. And he, that was in a majlis in Ramadan, after he finished Salat Tarawih. He came to the book of the Imam al-Ghazali, he was asking, can you explain what the Al-Ghazali means in this book? Discuss together. I asked him a question. He said, if you don't mind, can I ask you a question? He said, yes. He said, how long have you been as a Muslim? He said, 3 weeks. Two or 3 weeks. He said, why you became a Muslim? What is the reason? Listen, he said, very simple answer, I found myself. I said, well, what that mean? Can you explain to me? He said, well, after September 11, it was a big problem. People attacked me, Muslims, defend themselves, they say, no, we are not something. I was confused, big confused. He said, well, I want to understand. Is it really there is a need to ask the people to pass themselves to kill others in order for them to enter paradise? Is it true? So he said, I must speak. He asked one of few of his students studying to bring two books about Islam. Alhamdulillah, they brought to him with books, the book of Imam al-Ghazali. Those books, which is famous everywhere in the world, there is no khilaf, no difference, no difference in opinions about these books. The books of Sheikh Abdul Jalal. He said, you know, when somebody read the book, it's been before 1,000, almost 1,000 years written. But if you read it without knowing the writer, without knowing who is writing, which year, you would think it's been written just nowadays. Talking about us. That is what we need nowadays. To follow the straight path of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is al-akhlaq, al-tarbiyah, the adab, etiquette. Sayyidina Rasulullah, he presented of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a great message. And Allah described the Holy Quran and said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, wa in laka la'ala khuluqin, azim, ya Rasulullah, you are in a high, exalted morality. Khuluq azim. Sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So we need to understand more about him alayhi salatu wa sallam and about his best seerah, biography. To know before he was born and when he was young. He was a prophet, as Allah said in the Holy Quran, in Surah Ali Imran. Please remember this ayah and ask your children to remember this ayah all the time by heart. Because if someone asks them, they can answer. Surah Ali Imran, ayah 81. Surah Ali Imran, Surah number 3, the Holy Quran, ayah 81. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وإذ أخذ الله ميثاق النبيين لما آتيتكم من كتاب وحكمة ثم جاءكم رسول يصدق لما معكم لتؤمنن به ولتنصرنه. قال أقررتم ما أخذتم على ذلك مصري؟ قالوا أقررنا. قال فاشهدوا وأنا معكم من الشاهدين. Translation: this ayah. And when Allah took the covenant of the prophets, that I have given you of the book and wisdom. Who's that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With whom? With whom? With the prophets. All of them. In the world of spirits, alim and arwah. That I have given you the book and wisdom. Then there shall come to you a messenger to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, confirming what is with you. You shall believe in him and you shall support him to be victorious. Do you agree and take my Lord on this? The prophets. Do you agree and take my Lord on this? They answer, we do agree. The Allah said, then bear witness and I will be with you among the witnesses. SubhanAllah, look how great ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the prophet, he was telling them, took the covenant from them. Al-Anbiya, all of them, Sayyidina Adam, Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, Yunus, Ayyub, Zakariya, Yahya, all telling them about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For any contract should be three parties. Party number one, the seller, the buyer, the seller, and the witness. Here, Allah, the messenger, the prophets, no witness. He asked them to be the witness, but their own self. Nobody can be witness about anything more than your own self. You will bring the witness if you want to prove something, but if you know that, you know it for witness because you already know. So Allah telling them, so you are the witness. Not only that, to show how great Sayyidina Rasulullah's position, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, then bear witness and I will be with you among the witnesses. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How great is Rasulullah? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the world of the spirit, Allah is still there. His prophet, and that he is coming to come with all his prophets. There's a peace. So, after the prophets came to know about Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the duty of it is to inform their ummah, their nation about him alayhi wa sallam. When they asked Rasulullah alayhi wa sallam, they said, Ya Rasulullah, talk to us, inform us about yourself. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أنا دعوة إبراهيم. I am the supplication of Ibrahim. When he supplicated Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was building Ka'batullah wa idh yarfa'u Ibrahim al-qawa'id. The Bayt Ismail, when he was building Allah's house, Ka'batullah, Ibrahim and Ismail, we have that minute. When we go to Ramah, the best place for you to ask Allah, Ibrahim is a dua of Sayyidina Ibrahim. and he is the good news of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, Nabi Isa alayhi salam. But Sayyidina Isa, remember this ayah also. It is in Surah As-Saff. Surah As-Saff, Surah number 61, ayah number 6 in the Holy Quran. Remember it and ask your children to remember it very well. He said, and when إذ قال عيسى ابن مريم يا بني إسرائيل إني رسول الله إليكم مصدقا لما بين يدي من التوراة ومبشرا برسول يأتي من بعد اسمه أحمد. And when Prophet Isa, the son of Maryam, said, Children of Israel, I am sent to you by Allah to confirm the Torah. That was before me, and to give the good news of a messenger who will come after me, whose name shall be Ahmed. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is in the Holy Quran. Muhammad Ahmed, that is Rasulullah's name in the Holy Quran. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he is the good news of Sayyidina Isa. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. If you go and read the Seerah Nabawiyyah, the book of Sayyidina Rasulullah, the biography of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, life story, you will see more of these, which will make you too glad and happy that you are one of the followers of this great nation, Ummatul Islam. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sent, listen to this, something very important. He was born alayhi salatu wasalam 571 years after the last prophet before him, which is Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. 571. And he is sent in a different environment, which is like all the prophets. Sent to Palestine, Syria, Yemen, that part of the world, Jordan. Now, we sent in a different environment, in a desert. 571 years, someone will say, so what? You know, each century, when there is a prophet, there will be more than one prophet each time. Yani Sayyidina Ibrahim, Lut, other prophets in one time. Sayyidina Musa, Sayyidina Shu'ayb in one time. And they are in different places. So the people, they used to hear Allah, to worship Allah, they used the prophet. Someone in the make them remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. 571 years, no prophet, no messenger. Now, if you're not going to read Surah Al-Fatiha for 1 year, going to forget Surah Al-Fatiha. How about 571 years? No prophet and no messenger. And he came to Mecca. The minute he came to Mecca, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after that 40 years when he became a prophet, alayhi salatu wa sallam, 600 plus years, nobody reached the last years. And around Ka'bah, 360 statues. Imagine the first house they built to worship Allah around 360 statues. What a very difficult mission. In what a very difficult environment. Desert, Bedouin, very rough and tough people. And he came from Allah alayhi wa sallam. He was Ummi. Ummi is me, illiterate. Why? Because Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is a negative. A negative, of course, if somebody was illiterate, he cannot be right, it's something negative, but on him is positive. Why? Because he has not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who favored him. And he is the only one who brought him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But don't want anyone in this world to say, I have done something to him. I have taught him something. him on any type of education. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you can, he knows all the stories of the Prophet Yunus, Musa, Isa, and Quran and Kareem. SubhanAllah. Many prophets, exactly like we see the Prophet, the story of Sayyidina Yunus, story of Sayyidina Sulaiman, story of Sayyidina Yusuf. Surprising everything. There's no internet, you know, by those days. But everything he got from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What Allah said to him? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In Surah Hud, ayah 120. وَكُلَّا أَقُصُّ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الرُّسُلِ مَا نُثَبِّتُ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ. And all we relate to you of the tidings of the messenger is that we strengthen your heart. All of them, you know, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he got all his knowledge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Exactly, nobody has done anything. What anyone can give you from the knowledge? What anyone can do for you if you have got all the knowledge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? For that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. وعلمك ما لم تعلم وكان فضل الله عليك عظيما. سورة النساء آية 13. He said, and he has taught you what you did not know, the bounty of Allah to you is ever great. Everything he has got from him, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He never taught by his desire, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He has no desire. Everything he was used to do by Allah's order, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wa ma yantiqu 'anil hawa. Nor does he speak out of desire. In huwa illa wahyu yuha. Indeed, it's not except a revelation which is revealed. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is a now understanding more about Sayyidina Rasulullah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is it? For us to be happy because we are one of the followers of him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What Allah giving him in the Quran? Nowadays when we pray, where is our Qibla? It's not the Qibla, where towards where? Towards Al-Masjid Al-Haram, Mecca, Al-Ka'b, Ka'batullah. Before it was there, Jerusalem. How it's been changed? Why Allah chose it first to be Jerusalem and after that he changed it to Ka'batullah? Because Rasulullah's wish. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was praying for many months towards Jerusalem, but in his heart he was hoping that Ka'batullah should be the Qibla of this woman. He never asked Allah, he didn't say, God, Allah, please, no. He had a wish only in his heart. And because of that, to please him, Allah, to please him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, فَلَنُوَلِّيَنَّكَ قِبْلَةً تَرْضَاهَا. He said, he shall surely turn you to a direction that you shall satisfy. That is for you. If God wants for you, to be satisfied. Allah changed the Qibla for Rasulullah's wish, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. If you are doing a job in your company, the boss was telling you, okay, this is what you should do, and if you are going to do a good work, you are going to be rewarded. If you love your boss, do more than what you said. And depends how much he loves you. If he call you many times, you say, come now, it's 3 o'clock, 3 a.m., but come now, we have something else. You won't say, why, what happened? You will say, yes, sir, I'm coming now. Because you love him. And you are very honest and sincere. وَلِلَّهِ أَفْلَعَى وَرَسُولِهِ صلى الله عليه وسلم. The great example of Allah and Sayyidina Rasulullah. Sayyidina Rasulullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, instructed him in that Holy Quran. How to call to Allah's power? Da'wah ila Allah. Allah taught him how to be taught to invite people to Islam. And this is a great sunnah. Now when we say we are Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we follow the sunnah of Rasulullah. The sunnah of Rasulullah not only how the way you pray, not only the way you fast, and not the way you sit, and not the way where you perform your Hajj or Umrah. The greatest sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is al-akhlaq. Wa innaka la'ala khuluqin adheem. Ya Rasulullah, this is Allah. He didn't say salat, adheem, and great salat. Akhlaq, because your akhlaq will bring all the good things to you, will bring khushur in your salat, will bring khushur in your fasting, will bring every good things to you. So say, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his duty and da'wah to Allah. What Allah told us subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran? And what the Muslim should do? Anyone who came or we want to be a da'i of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, go invite others of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how we should behave? Everything is said for us. Al Quran al Kareem. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. ادعو إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة وجادلهم بالتي هي أحسن إن ربك هو أعلم بمن ضل عن سبيله وهو أعلم بالمهتدين. Listen to this. This is very important for everybody. For all of us nowadays. For anyone who wants to be a good Muslim and to ask others to be a Muslim. He said, call the path of your Lord. Came to Rasulullah and we follow the Sunnah of Rasulullah. Say, call to the path of your Lord with wisdom and find admiration. Dispute with them in the best manner. Your Lord is well aware of those who have gone astray from his path and he is well aware of those who are guided. So, the hikmah, how is it should be? Call Allah's path, wisdom, find admiration, and the aqeel should be in best manner. That's how the Islam is spread everywhere in the world with the khul, the akhlaq, the behavior of the Muslims. How they behave, that in Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is beside his house a Jewish person, Medina, Jewish. Bring his rubbish from the house and put it in front of Rasulullah's house, from in front of the Rasulullah's entrance. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how great is your rahmah and ala everything. He can't be killed by himself. Never complain to anyone. He never complained to Allah. One day he came up sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw there is no rubbish. And he, the person, in the cup, gone to his house and knocked the door. He opened the door. How are you? Are you okay? Your health is good? Your everything is fine? That's what he said. What is this? I miss you today, you know? So, he said, Wallahi, you are the real messenger. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. If you are going to read the books of the world to ask them to be a Muslim, you won't be a Muslim. But the akhlaq of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are coming to this part. So Rasulullah, his da'wah was so excellent. And he followed what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed him, that Allah didn't reward him anything, but he gave him a special reward. He said to him, after you know, you say, you follow God to the path of your Lord with wisdom, with the fine admonition. He said, after that, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Ya Rasulullah, surely you are of a great morality. After that, he done that good job, and the reward is a supply of the Quran. Teach it, please, to your children. Remember this ayah. This ayah in Surah Al-Qalam, they call it Surah number 68, ayah number 4. Surah Al-Qalam, they call it Surah Al-Qalam. surah number 68, ayah number 4. It's talking about your beloved Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's what we should know about him alayhi wa sallam. He was a great rahmah. He was a great mercy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, okay, this was too merciful. And Allah asked him, بالمؤمنين رؤوف. First he said بالمؤمنين, for the believer, too gentle, too merciful. بالمؤمنين. But he was not only for the المؤمنين, not for the Muslims. He was merciful to everyone, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even to the animals. If you go and read his biography, you see one day that visited somebody, and there is all of a sudden a camel. Rasulullah came up and he was looks like whispering to Rasulullah's ear. So Rasulullah said, this camel belongs to me. Somebody said, this belongs to me, Ya Rasulullah. Say, the camel now came to me that you have brought him home and give him a little food. And you don't allow him to rest for a good time. The camel complained from me to Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So what Allah said to him after that? The person said, Ya Rasulullah, this camel who complained to you, he is free from now. But he won't do anything. He got his freedom. He is not one of them in my service. SubhanAllah, the camel. What Allah said after that? وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have not sent you, Ya Rasulullah, except as a mercy to all the worlds, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rahmatullah. What a great Al-Quran came. If you go and eat everything, everywhere you are going to read Al-Quran, there is something describing Sayyidina Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And his akhlaq, and how he deal with others, alayhi salatu wasalam. We have reached to get the highest title that Allah used to give to his servants, which is abd, servant, Allah's servant. The Prophet al-Musa'in, Sayyidina Adam, he want me to be in the name of father of all humanity. And Sayyidina Ibrahim is not happy with the name of the father of all the prophets, Abu al-Anbiya, more than his happiness if Allah said, Abdullah, my servant. That is a great, that is a great name. Sayyidina Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he was too humble, too simple. And he was a great example, an excellent example. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how he described it. Surah al-Isra, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Subhan al-Ladhi asra bi'abdihi layla, Subhan al-Ladhi asra bi'abdihi. He said, exalted is he who carried his servant. He didn't say his prophet, he didn't say his messenger, his servant of Allah. That is what they want. See, in the Quran there's something very interesting. Whenever Allah called any prophet by his name, by servant, he will put, come together with his name. يعني ذكر رحمة ربك عبده زكريا. عبده زمن زكريا. The name is there. واذكر عبدنا أيوب. واذكر عبادنا. The name when he was servant. Rasulullah's name. Rasulullah's when he was trying to serve. Never kept together with him. Alhamdulillah, الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب. He revealed the book, he revealed to his servant. He didn't say Muhammad. سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده. He didn't say Muhammad. And Allah ayat in the Quran. Why? Because he was the greatest of Allah's servant. That when Allah said بعبده, nobody would come to your mind on Ya Rasulullah. Only صلى الله عليه وسلم. Nobody will come to him. He was, how he got that? You know, what they did of Al-Isra? What happened to him, alayhi salatu wasalam? Allah carried him in one night from Al-Masjid al-Haram from Mecca to Jerusalem, one night. And it's supposed to take 1 month. They traveled for it to take about 1 month. Not only that, to the seven heavens, all are done in one night. Why? Abdi. Where is the difference here? Iblis. Iblis. He was in the heaven, but he rejected Allah's order to sujood to Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. When Allah affected order the angel to sujood, he was there. He's the jinn. He was not an angel. But he had reached to that high level because he was a good worshipper of Allah. He was a good servant. But the thing inside him, there is something very dangerous who made him to refuse. I never obeyed Allah's order to sujood to Sayyidina Adam. What is that? إلا إبليس أبى واستكبر تكبر. See, how come I do sujood to Adam? I'm better than him. He's from clay, I'm from fire. I was there for a long time. Why? So because of the brother, Iblis, تكبر, he been thrown out from heaven to the earth. But because of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he been carried up from the earth to the heaven. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why? سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده. This is something very important about the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, which we need to understand. Every part of his stories of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, his life story, it's something great. One of the greatest things which Allah really needed to think of it. We've been created as a Muslim, alhamdulillah rabbil alamin, to be Allah choosing you to be the followers of this Ummah. What do you need to do now? To prove to Allah that you are a good servant and you are a good follower of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. The love of the Sahaba to have to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is more than you imagine. As Sahaba, they know the Quran by heart. And they are the men, they have sacrificed their soul for the sake of Allah and for the sake of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But one day, they said something very important. One eye of the Quran is somebody who came to Rasulullah in Sahih Muslim, the book of Muslim. Sahih Muslim. One day a man came to see Ya Rasulullah. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, when will the day of judgment arrive? When? See Ya Rasulullah said, what have you prepared for the day of judgment? Now there is a film recently, they said 2012. From now, what we have prepared for it. Allah knows where is the judgment day. But the question, if somebody asks me, are you ready for the judgment? Not judgment. Are we ready now to leave this life? Are we ready for the question of the two angels who come when they came in the grave? Now I can say, who is your Lord of God? Who is your Prophet Muhammad? But in the grave, you cannot say that. Your deeds will allow you to say that. We'll stop for a while for assumption. السيدة عائشة رضي الله عنها أم المؤمنين، she came to him and she said she was very happy and he was pleased that night. So she said, Ya Rasulullah, can you please pray for me now at this minute? But come secretly and open what she had done. She was very excited, very happy with that dua, because Allah's, the Rasulullah's dua was guaranteed that his dua will be accepted for sure. وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرَضَى. Allah will keep giving you until you satisfy. And he's, imagine, he's رَحْمَ الْعَالَمِينَ. He won't be satisfied unless he makes sure that all of his ummah go to the Jannah, inshallah. In the last subhanAllah. She was very happy. Then Sayyidina Rasulullah asked her, Ya Aisha, are you happy with my dua? She said, how come I not be happy? I'm not the one who prayed for me. He said, Ya Aisha, do you know that this is my dua for my ummah? In each prayer, I pray to Allah subhanAllah. Each time he prayed to Allah, Allahumma fir li ummati ma qaddamat li bayfan sallallahu ta'ala alayhi. How great. The Sahaba, with all of these, with all of Quran describing, with what Allah giving him, and they know his high position, alayhi salatu wassalam. They look to him, when they look to him, when we read about him, they look to the one who Allah sent him the praise, that not a single prophet, and a single angel coming to reach what we have in sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They look to his eyes, to the hand, the Sahaba, Sahih al-Bukhari, we need to read Sahih Bab al-Akhlaq, Bab al-Manaqib, Sahih al-Bukhari, Sahih Muslim, all these books we need to read about it. No need for us to argue about the difference between argue. We need to read about the difference which is for sure is there about him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Quran and Sunnah. When they used sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they say, one Sahaba said, Rasulullah came back from his house, it was a very hot weather. I kissed his hand from here, from his hand, the palm. It was too cool, and the smell from his house, I heard the perfume, the musk, remained with me for 3 days. There is one Sahabi, his name Abu Mahdura, Sahih Muslim, Abu Mahdura Sahabi, his forehead, you know, the hair from here, the forehead. Too long. He never cut it. They said, why? He said, I won't cut it after Rasulullah has touched by his hand, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In Sahih Muslim, Ummu Salim radiallahu anha, the lady she was taking care of her, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, no, Rasulullah used to go to her house and rest there and sleep there. She used to take his sweat. When he sweat, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she put it in a bottle. When he asked her why did that, she said, to mix it with my perfume and to keep it as a medicine for our children. He said, of course, of our wives. It's all Sahih Muslim, Sahih Bukhari. It's all there. But we are not teaching them about the greatness of Sayyidina Rasulullah. Allah venerated him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised him in the Holy Quran. If somebody now, if you are working somewhere, then every day there will be promotion for you. Every day, not every year, every day, promotion from position to higher position. You will be wondering why I'm getting this. But Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is getting his promotion not from anyone, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa innaka la'ala khuluqin. Who described him? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ma arsalnaka illa rahmatan lil alamin. Alam nashrah laka sadrak. Wa la sawfa yu'tika rabbuka fatarda. Inna Allah upon Rasulullah, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallim taslima. Holy Quran. This is only in the Quran Kareem. Allah swear by his aid, la'abrika. I swear by your aid, Ya Rasulullah. He swear by his love, sikkar, man, wa antahim. I swear by the city, because you are in this city. Quran is only Quran Kareem. is to show us the greatness of Sayyidina Rasulullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even with his permission, Sayyidina Rasulullah used to fast every Monday. Why he used to fast every Monday? That was sunnah for us to fast Monday and Thursday, you know. But why he used to fast every Monday? The Sahaba, they saw him fasting every Monday. As it's our love to Sayyidina Rasulullah, is as the love of Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, and Sayyidina Umar. Our love to Rasulullah is loved, you know, with laziness, but we still love him. But the Sahaba, they love him. They have left everything. They will do everything for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because of the love. SubhanAllah. The way when he looked to any of them and he said, and he talked with him nicely, the way they sit in front of him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, oh, God is there in a sunnah. In the books of the sunnah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one, he is the one who is the sunnah. Oh, what we can say, as Imam al-Busiri in his book Al-Burda, which is inshallah coming tonight to celebrate all of us. Mawlid al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recite the Burda, which has been recited everywhere to praise him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the book, in this the poem, this Burda, the dawn of the clock, they call it. He said, beautiful saying, he said, for very excellence of the Messenger of Allah has no limits. No limits that a speaker might be able to express with his tongue. Nobody can say. After what Allah said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, about himself, he used to fast every Monday. And when a sahaba asked him, Rasulullah, with the love, why you are fasting every Monday? He said, that is the way, the day I was born. That is my birthday. Every week, Sayyidina Rasulullah celebrated, is a student. Fast every Monday. And the reason, Rasulullah's birthday, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When a Sahaba have heard that, what they have been, next Monday, they came, all of them fasting, and Medina, all of them, their children, everybody fasting, to say what, if you ask them, why you're fasting, Ya Rasulullah, we are celebrating the day where he was born. That is the love, the mahabbat we have to Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What the Sahaba, what is the best ayah in the Quran? A Sahaba, they were very happy with this ayah. When the messenger person asked him, Rasulullah, about the judgment day, you remember this time he said, Rasulullah asked him, what do you have prepared for the day of judgment? The person said, the love of Allah and his messenger. The love of Allah and his messenger. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then, what happened? Thereupon, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught him, then you shall be with whom? Shall be with whom you love. Sayyidina Anas radiallahu anhu, Anas radiallahu anhu said, apart from entering Islam, nothing has made us happier than the words of the Messenger of Allah, you shall be with whom you love. That was the best for all of us. And I myself, Sayyidina Anas, continue saying, and I myself too, love Allah and His Messenger, and Abu Bakr, and Umar, and though I have not been able to match what they have done, I accept to be with them. My love, inshaAllah, will carry me to be with them. Our love to Allah, our love to Rasulullah, our love to As-Sahaba, our love to Ahlul Bayt, our love to As-Salihin, all those who they have done a great job for the Ummah, they elevate the name of Islam higher and higher. We should love them too much because we hope that we are going to be with them. You know Abu Lahab, tabbat yada Abi Lahab. Abu Lahab, he is fire, jahannam. Allah said, but you know that every Monday, hadith al-Sahih Bukhari, there is one that every Monday he will suck water, cool water, he's in jahannam. But from his both fingers, every Monday, he's been allowed to cool water. Why that happened? Sayyidina Abbas, Sahaba, Sahib Adri, he said, because when Muhammad born, Sayyidina Rasulullah was born, the lady, she was the slave, and if Thuwayba, she came to him and she said, I couldn't use Ya Abu Lahab. Your brother Abdullah, the late brother Abdullah, his wife just born to a baby boy, and they call him Muhammad. When he hit him, he said, you are free from now, freedom. You are no more slave. Because of that, every Monday the youth give him this book, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to put it in water. Because he was happy with Rasulullah, sallallahu ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran, even al-Nadina, yaquluna, al-adab. This is the adab. This is ayat al-adab. Surah al-Hujurat, remember? Surah al-Hujurat is surah number 49 in the Quran. Please go and read the first, second, third ayat, verse Surah al-Hujurat. Look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How the Sahaba used to behave in front of him. They never, in Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَرْفَعُوا أَصْوَاتَكُمْ فَوْقَ صَوْتِ النَّبِيِّ وَلَا تَجْهَرُوا لَهُ بِالْقَوْلِ كَجَهْرِ بَعْضِكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ أَن تَحْبَطَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. Oh, you who believe, do not raise your voices above the voice of the Prophet. And do not speak loud to him as you speak loud to one another. Do not call him by his name. Don't say, Ya Muhammad, Ya Rasulullah. Because you won't find in the Quran a single ayah, a single verse of the Quran, Allah said, Ya Muhammad. You have said, Ya Isa, Ya Musa, Ya Ibrahim. But always, whenever you call Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Ayyuha al-Nabi, Ya Ayyuha al-Muzammil, Ya Ayyuha al-Mudaththir. Give him title. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. What happened if somebody missed his behavior? Or he just a little bit, you know, he said, don't speak loudly with him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, for if somebody have that, say, and do not speak loud to him, as you speak loud to one another, for then your good deeds will be erased. The good deeds will be erased. Allah used this word, tahbata a'malu, Quran twice. One in shirk, mushrik, somebody in a'udhullah, mushrik, that one is deeds will be erased. And if he misses behavior in front of Rasulullah, it's a sin for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One sahabi, his name is Abu Ibn Qais, and Sahih Ibn Bukhari. When this ayah been revealed, you know what he have done? When this ayah been revealed, he used to pray five times prayer. You know, there's a great chance to pray with Rasulullah. From that day, he never used to pray with Rasulullah. He stayed at home after this ayah been revealed. One day, Sayyidina Rasulullah said, where is he? One sahabi said, Ya Rasulullah, I will go and bring the news. He gone to him, he saw him in a very bad situation. He said, Ya Khalid, what's happened to you? He said, it's evil. Why? His voice, naturally loud voice. There's people, their voice is loud voice, naturally. They've been made like that. He said, it's evil. A man who used to raise his voice over the voice of the Prophet, and so all his deeds, all his good deeds have been erased. And I'm going to go to him. Subhanallah, this is a command. Adam. It's not adam, not a decay. It's a perfect etiquette towards Rasulullah. Then the person went to Rasulullah and said, Ya Rasulullah, this is what happened. Said, because Sayyidina Rasulullah said to him, to go and say to him, you are not from the people of fire, but you are from the people of Jannah. With his adam, the intention. Ya akhi, if you want to say something about Rasulullah, say something about him. Don't argue, please. Leave the argument. Don't put yourself in a situation you don't know you are sure or not. If the word came out from your mouth and that word was wrong and you think it was right, when you speak about Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will lose dunya and akhirah. A'udhu billah. Dunya and akhirah. Quran. Allah says, if you want to say something good, or be silent. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a word will come from the mouth of somebody. He won't take care of him. Not concerned. He will fail down to that word in Jahannam 17. If I want to say something about him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I will say something good and praise him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let us do something in order for us to make our children and our families bless one another. Let us sit with them every week once and read one page from Rasulullah's biography. There's a book of Sirah. One page, once a week, they will get the blessing, number one. And Allah, He is like that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, they will be protected. Number four, they will know more about Sayyidina Rasulullah. So there will be many things. And that will be for you, sunnah hasanah. Sunnah, as when we celebrate Maulid Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what do we want from that? We want to be close to Allah. We want to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To his beloved Prophet Sayyidina Rasulullah. And if Allah asks me in the judgment day, why you celebrate the Mawlid? Why you celebrate the Mawlid of Rasulullah? Why you celebrate on this day? Today is 28th of February 2010 in Masjid Al Mukarrama with the people, and you have listened the talk of my beloved Prophet Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And you have recited salawat al-mulka, salawat. Allahu malaikat of Allah wants a salawat. Why you have done this? What do you have to say? Ya Allah, because of your love and your beloved Prophet. So what do you think Allah will say? Go to him. Huh? He said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Rasulullah said, and you say, no, Rasulullah, he said, he will be with whom you love. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We don't want our heart to be hard-hearted. There are many good things we can do nowadays in order for all our problems to be solved and our life to be peaceful life, to remember Allah and see God. Sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And that will be the inshaAllah. No second. And Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in my dear brothers and sisters, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Remember this ayah, Surah Yunus. Surah Yunus, ayah 51, Surah Al-Ayah. Surah number 10 in the Quran, ayah number 58. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Qul bi fadlillahi wa bi rahmatihi fa bi dhalika falyafrahu. Say, in the bounty of Allah and His mercy, let them rejoice. Let them be happy. And you think, what is the best of Allah's rahmah? Rahmatan lil alameen. Better. There is nothing more than that. The one who's going to ask shafa'ah, the session for him in the judgment day. When the sun going to come near, closer and closer towards us. That this way will be the flood going to fall down from the fences. Then they will shout, they will call, quiet and Imam Muslim. Ya Isa, Ya Ibrahim, they will call, help us, please, istighatha. Istighithu, Rasulullah said, istighithu, Nabi Ibrahim. They will come to Rasulullah and say, yes, that is my position. Al-Shafa'at al-Wuthma. He said to each prophet, there is a da'wah, one guaranteed da'wah, who to be sure accepted. And I ask Allah, Ya Allah, keep my da'wah, al-Shafa'at for my judgment day. I want to ask the judgment day for my Alhamdulillah. And he's going to ask Allah for you. Before you introduce yourself to him, before you say, I am Fulan, Rasulullah will say, Ahlan wa sahlan, so on and so on, by name, inshaAllah. In the last one, inshaAllah, with his heart, we will be close to him and to his beloved Prophet, Rasulullah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Pray, inshaAllah, we pray to Allah, Ya Allah, while we are in this blessed month, in this blessed gathering. We pray to you, Ya Allah, to be a pillar of the list. We are, you know, we have done so much things in our life, but we ask Ya Allah first to purify our hearts. Ya Allah, to make your love and your love, perfect love, to know ourselves as more than anything in this life. Ya Allah, if you want us to, want to bless us with dunya, bless us to love the dunya in our hand, but your love and your love, perfect love in our heart. Ya Allah, bless us to follow His path and akhlaq, to do the best. To our families, to our brothers, sisters, humanity, to our country, to contribute more, because that will elevate our position and bless us to be closer to humanity, closer to your beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Allah, if you want, bless us to control our tongue. If you want to say something, you say a good thing. To say good things about anybody, and to be a good Muslim, be akhlaq. Change our soul, Ya Allah. Make the soul absolute and even. And call the soul when it's going to leave this life, as you have said in the Quran, in the Quran, in absolute and even. Virgin, in the Quran, in the Quran, Ya Allah, please our souls. And may Allah help us to please You in our life, and to please Your beloved prophet, Ya Allah, bless us to recite more salawat upon Him. Because this salawat for sure going to be accepted. Because Allah is there and you are there, it will be, of course, will be, inshallah, will be accepted. And Rasulullah and Sahih Bukhari have said, if anyone recites one time of salawat upon him, Allah will elevate his situation 10 degrees and erase from him, from his head, 10 of his sins, and he will increase his goodness. My day, inshallah. We want to give this barakah to all of you. And I wish to say thank you so much for inviting me. Thank you so much to our brothers. They read this place, the invitation, the committee of this message. May Allah bless all of you, all the committee of the Egypt. Barakah, good health, long life, strong iman for you, for your families. Inshallah, to do the best for Allah's path. Surah al-Mustaqeem, inshallah, always. And pray to Allah, we say, Ya Allah, as You have blessed us tonight to leave the TV and for this 1 minute and to be here to listen to the Quran and Sunnah and Hadith and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Allah, we ask You to repeat this verse again, to meet again, bismillah, and to meet again in the best and better place, which is Jannat al-Firdaws, inshallah, together. والمرسلين والصحابة وأهل البيت والصالحين والتابعين والعلماء إن شاء الله بإذن الله سبحانه وتعالى أن نبرر الله بزر الصحبة الحسنة إن شاء الله. Now after صلاة العشاء إن شاء الله we are going to take more from your time, but this time we're going to recite together صلوات upon رسول الله. And we recite the word. The word is used everywhere in the world, everywhere in the world. Millions and millions of people. Is the way that they exalted, strive to exalt the noble prophet Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam situation, and that will bring to us the rahmah and barakah in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they used to recite it whenever they have any problems or any wish to be fulfilled, inshallah, they used to recite it as well in order for them to get this barakah. So inshallah tonight after Salat Isha, we come to do that and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us our little. آمين يا رب العالمين. ربنا شكرنا وحمدنا وقبل منا وسامحنا وتب علينا وبارك علينا وبارك على جماعة الحاضرين والحاضرات ورزقكم الصحة والعافية والسلامة والتوفيق والهداية في الدنيا والآخرة والمسلمين والمسلمات المؤمنين في الأحياء والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وصلى الله على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك كيف تنكر حبه؟ Oh, Yeah. أبيت ولا عسير إلا بفضلك يسر. هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وقنا عذاب النار وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا برحمتك بلطفك بجودك بكرمك الجنة دار القرار. يا عزيز ويا غفار ويا أرحم الراحمين إلهنا تقبل دعاءنا منا وأجري أرواحنا الخفية في كل أمورنا واجعلنا من الذين سبقت لهم منك الحسنى. إنا قد أرسلنا إليك من نبي وآل وصحبه وسلم الفاتحة.
Ma spendere di questo, poi che è un'altra cosa.